have you. Amen. Amen. All right. AdamandBeliever.com/afallenaway.pdf. The Bible speaks of a falling away happening near the time that the day of the Lord happens. It says the day of the Lord won't come unless there be first a falling away. So we're going to talk about the falling away, and we're going to talk about those that's falling away. Amen. You know, every now and then, we're not the kind of church, I don't preach truth, pine, hip hop every week, but every now and then, I got to deal with the stuff. Because these folks are doing things that are deceptive in the body of Christ, and somebody has to say something. Amen. Amen. And I've dedicated my life to the Lord that if you want me to say it, I'll say it. So we're going to talk about this, and maybe from right to, is it left to right? Right to left. Left to right. Kurt Franklin and Stephen Furtick and Joel Osteen, T.D. Jakes, and Tyler Perry, and the new one, Mike Todd. And most people don't know Mike Todd is antinomian. His father in the gospel is Carlton Pearson. So I expect nothing. He ain't surprised me yet with his antics and what he is doing. He basically is pastoring Higher Dimensions 2.0 in Tulsa, which was Carlton Pearson's old church. But anyway, this is what they do, and you know, it's just what's happening. So, amen. If you're easily offended by somebody calling this kind of stuff out, then you wouldn't be here. So, all right. Anyway, amen. We're going to start with this passage in Habakkuk. Very important passage. Oh, very important to what we are talking about now. And I was listening to this song on, it was on Saturday Night Live, the Jonas Brothers. Y'all remember them, right? They started out gospel, now they're secular. Well, they performed on Saturday Night Live with Kurt Franklin. But they were doing this song and they kept saying, even the walls will cry. And, you know, I'm just like, okay, what is this? And the album hadn't come out yet, so you can't really find the lyrics, but I found a copy of the lyrics, and I was listening to him sing, and, of course, Kurt was jumping around doing his thing and yelling. It's like, what is he yelling? They didn't even have his mic on. But I said, why are you yelling and they didn't turn your mic on? That's embarrassing. But he was just, he's like a prop, and he's just up there just jumping and screaming, and they kept singing this line, you know, if you leave me, I will die. And even the walls would cry. And I was like, man, what is it with the walls crying? Like, what is that? Holy Spirit spoke to me and said, it's not the walls crying, it'll be the stones in the wall that will be crying. From this passage right here in Habakkuk, for the stones shall cry out of the wall, because the wall was built in sin. So it's saying that all that you have built from selling out is gonna accuse you on the day of the Lord. I said, wow. How many truth behind hip-hops I've done and I didn't know that? Wow. So let's read the whole thing. He says, woe unto him who obtains wicked gain for his house, who thinks by doing so to set his nest on high, that he may be preserved from calamity and delivered from the power of evil. So these are people that build their kingdoms and their houses on wicked gain, by selling God out, and they think because they're so famous and so high, calamity won't come over them. He said, you have devised shame to your house by cutting off and putting an end to many people, and you have sinned against and forfeited your own life. For the stones in that house you built will cry out of the wall built in sin to accuse you, and the beam of out of the woodwork will answer it, agreeing with its charge against you. Woe to him who builds a town with blood and establishes a city by iniquity. My God, today. Give me about 6 minutes and I'll be back.
filthy with envy. I'm set free of trust.
Check me out. I'm getting to the money. Everybody, man. I think I'm getting too much money. Everybody, man.
As we were saying, Dragon, this is what you need to do. Step one, find you a baddie.
Okay.
But step two,
she gotta have a baddie.
Hey.
Hey. Hey. So, hey.
Yeah.
Look back at it.
Uh-oh.
What is she doing?
Friends, I don't have a fatty.
Girl, we keep telling you it's okay.
Your little booty matter too, friend.
Oh, yeah. Y'all know they don't be discriminating.
What should happen is you should go from property to soldier to bishop to king.
Amen.
No one's trying to suck you guys back into the church. Praise God for where you are. It's time to be kings. And it's time to walk in that favor that's on your life. Don't let anybody tell you that you're not anointed if you're not in the church. There's an anointing to be king. David was anointed to be king.
Sure.
And there's nothing wrong with being a king who is a poet, who is a prophet. That's what's on you, son. And walk in it.
Yes.
Have confidence in it. And God will use you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
All right.
Oh, I like this.
Twerking for the Lord. We do not think you're going straight to hell, as some people have said.
Oh, church girl got a potty mouth.
Ain't gonna be a sanctified transmission.
Hey, baby.
Oh. Oh my gosh, I've always wanted a sister, and here is my cousin sister, Sam. She's from LA, staying with me now.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Melissa, captain of the praise team. Let's take it from the top.
Break every chain.
What?
Yeah. It's gonna be great.
We are terrified.
I don't really have a relationship with God.
God used fish, donkeys, even hoes to get his word across.
What's going on?
What are we gonna do?
I've been praying all night. God gonna come through. I gotta smash. You blessed her with that. With that.
You gonna mess around and get an STD.
Signs only.
I'm gonna be all right.
You should sing this song at that church thing.
I don't want to be that anymore. I want to be a mother. This song is activating demons that I locked away a long time ago. And it's coming back again. And I don't want to be that. I want to be a good person. I don't want to.
That's because I recently took the boys to their first Clemson game.
Justin Bieber, probably.
Yeah.
Jennifer Aniston.
Yeah. Oh, you want to meet him?
Yeah.
You want to call him right now?
Yeah.
Who? No, you're kidding.
Yeah, no, we'll call him right
wait,
now.
Wait, who? No.
I don't know. We're gonna FaceTime him right now.
No. You're joking.
If he hops on, I'll
guys, can he go to a rhythm night?
Oh, yes. Oh, he's really doing it.
No, you're kidding.
Guys, don't freak out. Just act like he's a nice person. He's a wonderful guy.
Can we have him at rhythm night?
That's what we're gonna ask.
So the stuff that was applicable for your grandmother means nothing to you. And so I said, I had a Zoom with all of my singles just this week, is that for me to tell 16-year-olds to be celibate is one thing. A 37-year-old who's used to getting some, I need a different kind of gospel.
Yeah.
So the church ain't telling me nothing about sex toys. They ain't saying nothing about the church telling me to be celibate. But my gynecologist is saying something got to happen down there because your stuff's shutting down.
Yeah.
So we got to have real gospel for grown-ups.
I'm about to go to me. I'm about to go to New York.
Once again, Jonas Brothers.
Yeah.
else I said today, remember, climb and maintain. If it's turbulent and there's trouble, go higher. Don't sit there. The devil is breathing down your neck. He's right where he's supposed to be. Because the Bible says you ought to say, get thee behind me, Satan.
Please be seated, you all. Thank you so much.
I'm still on that song. We go from glory to glory to glory.
We're going to keep going.
Never change.
That's so good. Well, we're going to talk for a few minutes, then I'll turn Tyler loose. I'm going to stay here the whole time. About this chair.
Y'all think the Lord ain't coming back soon? That's unreal. I'm not going back in any of the video because it pretty much didn't need a commentary if you know the word. And the sad part is most people don't know the word, or their feelings are more important than the word. So they can relate to that because that's the lifestyle they want to practice. Believing you are in God, but really you're not. Revelations 2 and 14, Jesus addressed this very thing way back in the book of Revelations. When he was judging the seven churches, he spoke to the church of Pergamum, the church at Pergamum in Pergamos. And he said, I have a few things against thee, because thou hast there them that hold the doctrine of Balaam, who taught Balak to do what? Cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel. In other words, put something in front of God's people that will make them fall. That's what a stumbling block is. Taught them to cast a stumbling block before the children of Israel, to eat things sacrificed unto idols, and to commit fornication. Balaam, most of y'all know him from the story of the donkey talking. Well, Balaam was just an idiot, but he was gifted by God for the time, and he thought to use his gifts to deceive Israel at Balak, the king's orders. And when he tried to curse Israel, I think it was three times he tried to curse him, and it didn't work. Balak devised another plan, which was for Balaam to use seduction of the Moabite and Midianite women to tempt Israel. In other words, cursing them wouldn't work, so he had to go in the back door and bring things in that would cause them to fall. Balaam, a prophet of Mesopotamia, was willing to use his God-given talents for financial gain. Balaam counseled Balak, the king, on the most effective way to weaken Israel. He advocated using seduction, using the Moabite and Midianite women to tempt the Israelites into sexual relationships and into pagan rituals. He sold out his gifts and talents to be used to weaken God's people. That's what you just saw in that collage. People who are using their gifts and talents to weaken God's people. It's unbelievable. Mike Todd, why would you bring that? That was his Easter service. And you got girls up there talking about their butts in front of the whole church. You had a woman on the cross? A woman? Church full of young people, but putting the right thing in there to cause them to stumble. Stephen Furtick talking to the youth. He talking about Justin. They ain't there to listen to him talk. You the pastor, and the youth was more excited about you calling Justin Bieber. And Justin didn't answer. And I know that whole story because I was involved in that. Brother Justin didn't answer. So that's what I'm saying. What are these people doing? And Cardi B, you get an opportunity to go to Cardi B. You got one job when you go to Cardi B. One job. That is to rebuke the devil and try to get her to come to Christ. What? That's all you do. You don't make no music with her. You don't play no music for her. This woman's crying out saying that demons are activated by the very music she's doing. And you go in there, you happy about recording with her? Then she's crying, having a meltdown. Who's to say the next meltdown she don't take her own life? Yeah. And Tyler Perry, that was the worst one to me. His brother's preaching at Lakewood. But every one of his shows are graphic, sexual, demonized shows. And on all the Queen's Men, there's an episode where they actually want to get back at a preacher. They mistake him for somebody else, want to get back at him, so they call a homosexual to come and rape him. And they rape the preacher on the show. That's who's preaching the gospel. Numbers 25, 1 through 3 says, and Israel abode in Shittim, and the people began to commit whoredom with the daughters of Moab. And they called the people unto the sacrifices of their gods. And the people did eat and bow down to their gods. So what happened is, once the men started sleeping with the daughters of Moab, it weakened them to the point to where they start worshiping the Moab's gods, worshiping Baal Peor. So they left God altogether because of them joining with the opposition. So when gospel Christians, whatever, join with secular entities, you weaken people. Then those people will begin to bow down to their gods. Then Israel joined itself with Baal Peor, and the anger of the Lord was kindled against Israel. Can I keep preaching? Yes. This doctrine crept into the church at Pergamum, and Jesus rebuked them for allowing this doctrine to go unchallenged in that church. The very reason this church was planted near the seat of Satan, which is the altar of Zeus, was to challenge the principality of pagan god worship. So the church was planted near this particular altar that you see on the top picture. This is the seat of Satan, the Bible calls it, but it's really, the real name is altar of Zeus. You know, God don't be playing. He ain't got no time to give Zeus a name other than Satan. If you a Greek god, you a devil. So he just said, that's the seat of Satan. No, that's the altar of Zeus. No, brother, that's the seat of Satan. Yeah, and so the church was planted there for these folks to fight against it and hold fast the name of the Lord and challenge the principality of pagan gods. Even though God praised their faithfulness, he had a problem with their passiveness toward those that love gain from wrongdoing. Revelations 2, 13 and 14 says, I know thy works and where thou dwellest, even where Satan's seat is. And thou holdest fast my name and hast not denied my faith. Even in those days where Antipas was my faithful martyr, who was slain among you, where Satan dwelleth. So right there at the seat of Satan, you guys have held fast. You haven't denied my name. Y'all been good. He said, but I got a few things against thee. Because you have them there mixing and merging the sacred with the profane. And I can't have that. So y'all doing good, church, but I got an issue with you allowing. Yes. Yes, allowing and not saying nothing. Yes. Allowing these folks to put a stumbling block before your children. Yes. Today, many churches are allowing this corrupt, deceitful doctrine to overtake their churches. You're like, well, why are they doing that? For the money. Did you think there was another reason? People are going astray and seeking gain for wrongdoing in the church. seeking gain for wrongdoing in the church. 2 Peter 2:15, forsaking the right way, they have gone astray. Forsaking the right way, that means you know the right way. But you're forsaking it, they've gone astray. They have followed the way of Balaam, the son of Beor, who what? Love gain for wrongdoing, record deals and entertainment deals. And y'all saw the pastor Andy Thompson talking to the Chance the Rapper. He gonna go from, I don't even know, it was so stupid. A king, and you a king. And he said, now we ain't trying to get you back in the church. I think he said stuck in church or something like that. Like, brother, you a pastor. And that's Chance the Rapper. You don't have no ministry for him, his life, for his brother, bisexual brother. You don't have no ministry for this dude. You promoting him and making him a king above the church. I start to post his giddy comment he had on his page. Ooh, I can't believe Chance the Rapper can't. They don't come visit here because they're going to have to get saved. Yeah. Amen. And then they got to make a real choice. They done came in here. They done sung everything. Now they got to make a real choice. You come get the gospel and you go do that? I don't want to be you. Amen. Because we're going to preach the truth in here. Amen. The Pinocchio prophets. Good gracious. Christ has a problem with Balaam's doctrine that was being practiced among the church. In the address to the church at Pergamum, he denotes three components of this false teaching. The first was stumbling. Somebody say stumbling blocks. Stumbling blocks were being cast among the people. They were not withstanding those that brought in damnable heresies that weakened the faith of believers and encouraged them to take hold of things that were harmful to them. Jamal Bryant, really? A new kind of gospel? Because women are older, they don't have to be celibate? That's a damnable heresy. You know why? Heresy is just a lie, an untruth. So that's an untruth, but it's damnable because it'll lead you to hell. Second Peter 2:1, but there were false prophets among you, even as there shall be false, but there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you who privately, secretly shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that brought them. And bring upon themselves swift destruction. When it says even denying the Lord that brought them, it's really saying denying what the Lord has told them. God called you to preach. You don't get to preach how you feel. God called you to preach. You don't get to make room for your flesh. You do that, you're denying the Lord, the very God that gave you the gift. Mm-mm. This is the Greek God family tree. Cronus and Raid had Poseidon, Hera, Zeus, and I'm trying to figure out this order because it don't make no sense. If Zeus is supposed to be the one, then how your daddy, Cronus? And how you equal to Hera and Poseidon? It don't make no. This is stupid. That's what it is, Elder. Confusion on Mount Olympus. Confusion. Who's in charge? What are y'all doing? But secondly, in that passage in Revelations, Jesus addressed the fact that they ate at the table with false gods and condoned what? False god worship. Somebody like, well, I don't worship false god. Well, if you pledge to a Greek fraternity or sorority, you do. You pledge Freemason, you do. You in Boule, you do. Well, my name is just on the roll, but I'm not active. Well, have you denounced it? You don't have to be active. The demon is already active. Have you denounced it? Well, this church ain't filling up with that now. Amen. I love that y'all are coming. But I want you to understand what we believe in here. We ain't filling up with foolishness. Amen. We don't take the cup of the Lord and the cup of the devil and mix the two. Amen. We don't believe in that. Amen. We ain't stepping to false gods in here with canes and foolishness. Chanting and scooey and woo and all that old foolishness y'all doing. We don't do that in here. We believe all that is demonic. That's false god worship. And God called those Greek gods devils. The Bible calls them devils. Said you don't sit at the table with devils. Drink the cup of devils. So don't fill this church up. I see you all around the corner, all the way to the back. But we ain't filling this church up with foolishness. Amen. Don't bring that agenda in here, because I'm going to preach against it every Sunday. Every Sunday. The Bible affirms. Well, let me back up. He addressed the fact that they ate at the table with false gods and condoned false god worship. Balaam practices would be equivalent to modern day pastors pledging to false gods of Freemasonry, Boule, Greek fraternities, and sororities. The Bible affirms that you cannot eat at the table of God and of false gods, mythological demons. 1 Corinthians 10 and 21. Ye cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of the devil. It's right there. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. You cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and then sit at the table with these. Amen. Pledging to Aphrodite and Athena and Apollo and Hermes. You pledging to these folks. He right there, Jack, in the meeting. He came to the meeting and he was on time. What we meeting about this time? We planning the Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday program. Yeah, they just having a meeting, planning something with the devil in all the what? Details. That's how you get paid, man. That's how you do. You sign that deal, you cut that deal. Yeah. And you got to turn it up. See, so I don't have no sympathy for folks that can't turn deals down. Brother, but you don't understand. No, you don't understand. They offered it to me too. Did they offer it to me, Robert? They offered it to us, didn't they? Turn it down. Turn it down. Yeah, and I'm going to turn it down every time. Yeah, but you don't understand. Yes, I do. Yeah, and folks thought I was crazy. I said, no. No, I ain't signing no deal with no devil. You mean I got to do what they tell me to do? You mean I got to partner up with people that are promoting things that are hurting young people? They singing songs that are hurting the youth. They are programming young people with sexually explicit foolishness in their lyrics, cussing, showing their... Cardi B! Teaching young girls to be sluts. And I got to partner with that for some money? Brother, no, because hell is hot and it's eternal. That's not worth the money for me, brother. No, 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 no. What would it profit a man to gain this whole world and lose his soul? Amen. Yeah, see the anointing you feel in this room? You know what that is? That's because I've gone through this stuff for real. That's what you feel. I didn't know it back then. I didn't know how important it would be during this time. Jay Brian, I didn't know this time would come. I didn't know it would get like this. But I know God, what God told me to do. And I had to do it. And now I can speak with an authority because I did do it. We ain't got to jump around on stage looking like an idiot. Doing the same thing I do to the gospel song, now I'm doing it to a song that don't make no sense. Christ addressed spiritual fornication, which is the mixture. This is the third thing in that passage. This is the mixture of false God doctrine with the doctrine of God. When people mix the sacred with the profane, they are committing fornication. Amen? Ministers that promote the world, its leaders, and the lust of the world are spiritual fornicators and in allegiance with the devil himself. You at the table with the devil if you're promoting the folks that promote the devil. Yeah, you can't make it right. You can't make it okay. You have to say no. Can't do it. No, I can't do that. I can't do that. I had one of the Dallas Cowboys back when I was doing music. Came to me and he said, man, we doing some rap. So I heard some of your stuff. Here's what I propose. I give you $10,000 a beat. Just make beats. My wife, remember that? $10,000. Now I'm broke. In that one bedroom, didn't have no money. $10,000. I said, man, you know I can't do that, man. Like, I'm saved. I can't be making. He said, here's what we do. You know your boy Daryl. He said, you make the beat, give it to Daryl. Remember that, babe? Give it to Daryl. Daryl give you 10 grand, he'll put his name on it and give it to me. My wife was right there. Because that night I grabbed her. I started crying, just like I'm crying now. I started crying. I said, she said, why are you crying? I said, because I can't do it. I'm crying. Because I can't do it. And then I told her, I said, when I come through all of this, I'm going to get the devil back. I'm going to get him back for making me feel like this. I'm going to stand on the truth. I'm going to preach the truth. No matter what it costs. And he going to feel what I got to say. And it's going to change things. He going to feel it. Because that wasn't fair. These folk come around me, all these artists and junk. Yeah, we love your message. Oh, yeah, we want to come visit. We want to be here. And then go do this junk. Bro, I ain't got no sympathy for what's about to happen to you. That's your choice. You choosing to do the fool. I could have made the same choice and I didn't. Amen. That ain't to show you me. That just shows you what we all supposed to do. We're supposed to turn the devil down and do what God tells us. Just like Jesus did on the mountain when he was tempted 3 times. He turned the devil down, told the devil, get behind me. The devil said, I give you all of this. Jesus said, I'd rather die than take anything from you. Matter of fact, I think I will. Ezekiel 22 and 26. And y'all know me better. I ain't trying to show y'all me at all. These are true stories. Ezekiel 22 and 26. Her priests have violated my law and have profaned mine holy things. They have put no difference. Listen, between the holy and the profane. They put no difference. Neither have they shown difference between the unclean and the clean. And have hid their eyes from my Sabbaths, and I am profaned among them. What does that look like? God is profaned among them? Yeah, that's that movie, Praise This. they profaned God's image, making it all about some singing. Got Chloe Bailey in there, who just did the explicit sex scene in the movie, in the show Swarm. Profane, all about the singing, just music. That sounds familiar, doesn't it? That sounds like Isaiah around Isaiah what? 11, Isaiah chapter 12. Yeah, word 14, Isaiah chapter 14. That sounds like what Lucifer tried to do. Yeah, it's exactly what it is. Revelation 2 and 16, repent or else I will come unto thee quickly. Quickly. And will fight against them with the sword of my mouth. I don't want to be them. Fight against them with the sword of my mouth. In Pergamum, capital punishment was done by running on the sword. Christ uses this symbolism as a threat to those who would not repent. He also called those that refused to repent them, which separates them from those that belong to him. Matthew 7 and 21, not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into, this is the scariest scripture in the entire Bible. Because you're talking about folks that are calling him, that are saying, Lord, Lord, folks that are casting out devils, folks that are healing the sick, working miracles, folks that are pastoring, leading. He said, all of them ain't with me. He said, not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, is going to enter into the kingdom of heaven. But he that doeth what? The will of my Father, which is in heaven. Are you doing the will? God wants you recording with Cardi B. God wants you making all the Queen's men. God wants you on stage with the Jonas Brothers doing a secular song. God wants you crucifying a woman on the cross. That's New Age symbolism. Women talking about their butts on stage in church on Easter, on Resurrection Sunday. No, only those that do the will. I know what you want to do, but is it the will of the Father? This is the girl, Chloe Bailey, that's doing the gospel music, singing the gospel songs, praise this. She has an album called Ungodly Hour, where her and her sister dressed like succubus. You know, the spirit that comes in the night, lays on top of you and takes your breath away and joins with you sexually when you in between realms. That's what they dress like. Calls wet dreams in boys. That's a spirit called succubus. That's who they're dressed like. That's why they called it the ungodly hour. Arrogance is one of many problems created by the doctrine of Balaam. Because you can't talk to them because they stars. They're celebrities. They reach out to me every now and then, don't they ever? But the arrogance, when I go to correct them, the arrogance, they gotta hang up. Well, I hang up. Most of the time, it's me. But they'll contact me. Brother, I'm feeling the way of the day. I told you. Don't sign the deal. But I already signed the record deal. I said, well, then just stop singing. They're going to take me to court. Well, they took Paul to jail. Stop singing. I mean, you act like I could just walk away from this. You better. You better. And it's so funny. Yo, you got a song out called Gotta Make a Way. You got a song called Gotta Make a Way. And God can't make no. The next song you record should be Spirit of Dumb. People that mix the sacred and profane usually recognize that they are sinners, but they refuse to change. People that mix the sacred and profane usually recognize that they are sinners. When Christ said, I will fight against them, he means that he would raise up those that would challenge them with the word. That's what I'm doing right now. I'm fighting against you. Hey, you got in the crosshairs. I'm fighting against you. And it ain't personal. I've just been raised up to do it. That's what he means. When he's going to fight against anybody, he's going to use his people. He's going to use his prophets. He's going to use those that will say what he tells them to say. Not those that will sell out. Not those that will merge the sacred with the profane. He ain't using them. They're using him. Matthew 7:22. Many will say unto me, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? And in thy name we cast out devils. Everybody prophesied now, though. And in thy name we've done many wonderful works. He's going to say, depart from me. I never. Oh, while you was doing that, I never knew you. Because you wasn't doing it for him. You were doing it for you. Regardless of the prevalence of idol worship surrounding the church at Pergamos, Christ did not allow them to partake in it at all. Amen. The sword was not just to cut people, but it was also used to forge a line of demarcation. 1 Peter 4:17, for the time has come that judgment must begin where? At the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of God? Summary. So many artists, actors, and church leaders are going after gain that produces stumbling blocks to God's people. And you can rationalize it all you want in your mind, but if you are producing stumbling blocks, if you are promoting stumbling blocks, then you're hurting people. You're hurting God's people. And their blood will be required at your hands. Every deal you signed, every song you made, every movie, film, all of that, their blood will be required from your hands. Man, I thank God, but we got a 10-piece band here. PJ, can I say Negro, is one of the baddest Negroes to ever. One of the greatest songwriters, players, musicians. Corey and Chris, and I could just go on and on. J. Matt, the drummer. Man, ain't many Native American drummers. That's a special anointing. We got these guys here. You don't think these guys could go and do something and elevate their level of income instantly? Well, most of them left that to be here. Yeah. Left that. You know why? What would it profit a man to gain this whole world and lose his soul? So we have fun in here like we playing for the Grammys. You can't tell us we ain't playing, we ain't Ray Chew and the crew. We enjoy it, look forward to it. Because when we go home, when we go to our jobs, when we go home to our wives and our family, we can sleep well. Because we ain't partnered with the devil. We haven't partnered with the enemy. We haven't taken gain for wrongdoing. Amen. I love it. And most of these guys in here, the businesses and different things, you know, most of these brothers in here didn't have nothing when they came to ABC. God done took them and now doing great things through them and business, all that, and they still come to me. Hey, here's the line. What you think about this, Pastor? I said, well, yeah, you cross that line, you might be dealing. And they ain't crossing. Well, then that's okay. Because I know it's not God. If I have to cross that line, I know it's not God. If I got to partner with something ungodly to get gain, then it's not God. That's the way we do it here at ABC. Amen. That's just it. There's a line. There's always a line. Look at somebody and say, there's always a line. I can't cross that line, brother. You can't sweeten the deal enough to make me cross the line. Amen. So many actors, artists, actors, and church leaders are going after gain that produces stumbling blocks to God's people. They love the fame and money so much that they will abandon the truth they once believed in order to prosper from the very things that harms believers. They make ungodly alliances with the workers of iniquity just to be rich and famous. This is exactly what Balaam did and why Jesus was not pleased with this particular church. It's time to repent. Repent for merging the sacred with the profane. Repent for accepting wages for the promotion of ungodliness. Repent for aligning yourself with the enemy. God is not pleased, and the end of all things is near. Revelation 2 and 17. He that hath an ear, let him hear. He that hath an ear. Everybody in here with an ear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. To him that overcometh will I give to eat of the hidden manna. That's what I want. I don't need the manna y'all can see. I want the hidden manna. And we'll give him a white stone. And in the stone, a new name written, which no man knoweth except the one he gave it to. That's what I want, a new name. I want a glorified body. I want to be with Jesus. I don't want your deal. I don't want your demons. I don't want to partner with the world. I want to be an overcomer. Everybody stand to your feet. He that overcometh. I want to be an overcomer. I don't know what you face with. I don't know what the devil is tempting you with. I don't know. But I do know this message was from the Lord. Amen. And if there's something you're tempted with, whatever it is, and God is saying, no, you need to be an overcomer. I want to pray with you today. Just come on up, whoever you are. Be an overcomer. Overcomer. Yeah, there's a lot of things I got to overcome. There's a lot of things I struggle with. There's a lot of things. Y'all, I'm a human being. But some things are no-brainer. Some things are no question. I'm not doing that. I'm not giving sacrifice in my life for that. I'm not signing that deal with the devil. I'm not merging the sacred with the profane. I'm not partnering with the enemy. It's not worth it. No. I received the word today. I'm an overcomer. I'm an overcomer. Hallelujah. I'm an overcomer. I want my name written on the stone. Hidden inside so nobody sees it. I want the new name. Yeah, I want to enjoy this life. Yeah, there are some things that help us enjoy this life more. They ain't worth my soul. Can't give you that. Can't do that. Can't do it. Can't do it. Can't give you that. No, can't sign that. I can't accept that. I can't agree to that. No, because I'm not losing my soul. Anyone else? Everyone just bow your heads. With your heads bowed, just say, I'm an overcomer. Speak it. I'm an overcomer. I'm going to overcome. I'm going to be the one. My name will be written on the stone. I'm going to be the one that will see Jesus face to face. I'm going to overcome. I'm an overcomer. So I'm here to overcome. Father God, we just thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for your presence in this place. We thank you for your spirit in this place. And Father God, we ask, Lord, that if there's been anything in our lives, God, that we accepted that we shouldn't have, Father God, we denounce it right now. We denounce it, whether it was a pledge or a promise, whether it was a deal that we signed or a deal we agreed to, whatever it was, whatever it is, it's not more important than you. So we denounce it right now in the name of Jesus. And we are overcomers, God. We will overcome this test, this trial, this tribulation. We will overcome, Father God. We won't partner with the devil in any kind of way. We won't agree to his terms in any kind of way. We won't allow him to take us away from our love for you, Father God. We won't allow him to come in between what we have with you. Father God, he can't take us from you. So we won't partner with him in any way. And we pray right now for strength. Lift your hands up right now. Strength, God, to endure this wicked time we're in. Strength, God, to not be influenced by these wicked preachers and singers and performers. We pray right now, Father God, that we will not fall away in this last hour. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we will overcome. We will overcome. Come on, just speak it. We will overcome. I'm an overcomer. I'm an overcomer. I'm an overcomer. We will overcome. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Come on and give God praise. Let's do something else. Just close your eyes one more time with me. Father God, we pray for every preacher, artist, everyone that was shown in this video. Father God, this wasn't a malicious attack from me. I'm doing my job. So we pray that it is not received that way when this message goes out. Father, that you will touch their heart and remind them of the original commitment that they had with you. Father God, I know I talked about Pergamum, but many have just lost their first love. Just become worldly and accepted things of the world. Father, I pray that you will help them, God. Bring them back to who their first love. Bring them back to their first love, Lord God. That they would receive you again. That they would receive your words, your truth, and that original agreement they had with you to use their gifts and talents and abilities for your glory, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on and hug somebody and say, I'm an overcomer. I'm an overcomer. I'm an overcomer. I'm an overcomer. Hug multiple people. I'm an overcomer. This is a test. And I'm an overcomer. Amen. Church at Ephesus left the first love. And a lot of times people get caught up. Amen. That's why you got to have. And let me tell you something. The devil has tried to cancel church for that very reason. This is why they're trying to cancel church, stop church. This is why folks are just vehemently against the gathering. Because the gathering produces an authority that can govern the gifts. That's what the church is. The pastor is a governor of gifts. And so he can oversee and watch over your gifts and your talents. So he can tell you, he can foresee He can see things you can't see, and he can hear things God is not gonna tell you, because you're not the pastor. So he can advise you, say, hey, don't do that. Hey, I wouldn't do that, man. I probably wouldn't do that either. But they want to cancel the church to end that authority so that people just do whatever they want to do. And they end up in those positions where they are merging the sacred with the profane. So keep praying for them. We pray for the preachers. We pray for the artists or whatever. But I ain't listening to you. I ain't supporting you. And I'm going to preach against you till you get right. Amen.